I think let's get started. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the last day of Connected Insights for this year. My name is Varun Malik. I'm the CEO of Konsälidön. We are a new age consulting firm powered by a digital platform. We host Connected Insights a few times a year. Connected Insights is a web summit where thought leaders from various parts of the world come and share their knowledge, their expertise on certain topics. Like I said, today is the last day for Connected Insights this year. This is the second last talk, so we're really, really looking forward to it. We started collaborating with Jeevan and Froogal about 6 months back and are really fascinated by the work that they do. So really looking forward to today's talk. During the talk, if you can please post your questions into the chat and we will try and point them out to Jeevan so that he can answer them. And after the talk, and even during the talk, if you have a question which absolutely has to be answered, then just raise your hands using the Zoom raise hands feature. And then after the talk, definitely you can unmute yourself, ask questions. We'd love to interact with all of you a little bit as well. So that's it from me. Jeevan, looking forward to our call, and over to you.
A very good morning to everyone. So firstly, before we start our session, I would like to take a moment to thank Mr. Varun and Konsälidön team for having arranged this webinar session, the secret recipe for a winning loyalty program. And also, I would like to appreciate all the attendees who have joined the session. So giving a little intro about myself, I'm the founder and CEO of Froogal.ai. Froogal is an omnichannel customer loyalty and engagement platform where we have been helping a lot of brands driving their customer-centric objectives and also drive their practices with respect to CRM, customer loyalty, and experience. I've been personally obsessed with always learning about new things coming out in technology, loyalty, customer centricity as a broad spectrum, and worked with many B2C and B2B brands creating their winning loyalty strategies and building CRM practices, driving them desired results. So coming into our actual discussion, if you look back 5 to 10 years back today, you'll see a huge transformation in the technology adoption by a lot of businesses. As consumers' demand have been kept growing, even the consumers' expectations also kept evolving, having been able to access anything, anywhere quickly today. And thus competition has also tremendously grown among the businesses. In the world of growing competition in businesses today and exponentially evolving expectations of customers, businesses really need to think in differentiating themselves in every factor to constantly grow. Today, while every business is striving towards growth, delivering the best product, best experience and service, business has a real need to connect with the customers more emotionally and drive their loyalty with them to consistently grow. Loyalty programs have come into light when there is a need for business to keep that X driving factor or another reason in the consumer's mind by giving some reward to make sure they don't go to another competitor. But loyalty doesn't just get built by rewarding customers. I remember telling a small example for a few who are at the nascent stage of understanding what loyalty programs are, or someone who thinks loyalty programs are just about rewarding when you need to build customer retention. So the example goes this way. So take like two friends like Fatima and Aditi, so who live together and have grown together. And Aditi seems to love always eating a double cheese pizza. And they both go out regularly for the same on every weekend. On one fine weekend, Fatima and Aditi are engaged with some daily work related stuff. Fatima reminds Aditi saying, "Hey, let's go out and eat your favorite pizza." And Aditi immediately responds back saying that, "Hey, I'm excited, let's go." What you can learn from here is Fatima knows about Aditi very well as a very close friend, what she likes, when she prefers to go out, where she would like to go on every weekend. The same relationship that Fatima and Aditi have built over time and learned about each other, the same relationship business and customer also should have. And that's what we call it loyalty. Customer loyalty is the result of business consistently knowing the customer and meeting them, exceeding their expectations. So loyalty programs aren't always about rewarding. It's also about winning consumers' mind and heart, as how you understand your best colleague or a friend as the time keeps moving and respond to them in an appropriate way. So having said that, a successful loyalty program does always, drive significant value and is very critical for business growth. Having a program that is scoring high on what we call it as loyalty performance score is strongly related with greater shareholding return, especially in airlines, retail, and multiple other industries. This measures loyalty performance score generally measures both how customers feel about loyalty programs and how well these programs drive value for the company. For instance, how often customers choose your brand over the others or pay more to earn a higher status within your brand. Typically, consumers who participate in the top quartile of the loyalty programs, you can clearly understand that 80% they are more likely to choose the brand over the competitors and twice as likely to recommend the brand to others. If you look at the slide, you can also clearly understand different consumer behaviors, how they are impacted with loyalty program from the data that we have collected with respect to comparing between top and bottom quartile of the customers participating in the loyalty programs, not just from choosing them over competitors, but also from perspective of spending higher amounts and also purchasing more frequently from the brand, and also even pay higher prices to stay with the brand. Having said that, loyalty programs are driving this kind of a significant value. So what we have seen in today's world is 90% of the loyalty programs fail majorly for two major reasons. So while every brand strives towards implementing loyalty programs that can derive them desired results, but 90% of them fail because of the lack of awareness and because of lack of contextual and emotional rewarding. So when you say awareness, if the customer is not even aware of what your USP and benefits that you are trying to extend through the loyalty program, of course the participation will be very less and thus the program will definitely fail. And you are rewarding customers today and the customer is not even aware of the reward and what kind of savings that they can make over these benefits and they never redeem them. And obviously there is no awareness and the program will fail. Besides this, most of the programs also fail because having said that customers are even aware of the benefits that you are giving, if your program is not having some emotional desire that it is driving towards the reward benefits, basically implementing a simple point system traditionally converted to cash until unless the cash incentive is way beyond. So customers will definitely not choose to participate in the loyalty program. So what we have done here is over the next couple of slides, we have put together a few fundamental principles that will help one design a program that can give you the best traction and puts you into the top tier of your top tier in your segment. So before I start talking about these four key principles, so I would like to share something with you. No matter what business you are in, there are only three ways how you can grow any business. So fundamentally, increasing the number of customers, your business will grow. Or either you persuade your customers to buy in larger volumes, or you encourage your current customers to buy more often from you. Every company have a need to develop that relationship marketing programs, especially with your key customers. By relationship marketing, what I mean by is something broader than loyalty points programs. So the four principles goes like this. So the first one that we talk about is tailor your program's benefits to the head and the heart. So it's no surprise what the feature loyalty members say they care most about in the program is monetary rewards. But it's very important to note that offering basic earn and burn points mechanism isn't just enough in today's market. Customers care almost as more about the company who makes them feel more special and recognized as they do the monetary benefits also do. So surprise and delight features like giving them unexpected gifts or doing a special recognition and delivering them exceptionally high value can be achieved at the low cost can definitely bring in a lot of differentiating factors. We need to definitely incorporate a lot of rational, emotional benefits within your program which can clearly give monetary and also a lot of special recognized benefits. And also you can incorporate a lot of social community benefits, donating points to certain causes and things like that. So the first principle that we talk about is you have to always meet a consumer's mind, and also you have to also always be in touch with their heart, having the program benefits also being designed in that way. So some of the examples, unique ways when what you follow during while you design your loyalty program is some of the fundamental models that you can incorporate are. So you definitely are going to have some kind of an earn and burn mechanism based on spend or visits that they're doing. So you technically probably implement some point systems or allowing customers to convert their points to certain freebies or benefits. So besides that, you also have to incorporate a lot of other models, something like surprise and delight, where you always surprise them for certain events or occasions that the customer is celebrating, or even define some exclusive perks within your loyalty program. So specifically for a certain behavior of customers, giving them some exclusivity offerings or a privilege or status with respect to within the program. So besides that, you can also always follow tier-based program when you have a large user base by dividing the customer segments into different behaviors and tier them and give them different privilege status in each tier and extend better benefits in each tier. So most of all, basically these being fundamental, so you can also incorporate a lot of gamification strategies within your loyalty program. For example, so always customers feel more privileged when they get a status. So for example, if a customer is doing 5 transactions in a streak in about like 3 months, and you call them a superstar and you assign them a badge. So implementing programs like badge concepts, assigning some badges for a specific behavior or desired actions that are done by the customer, definitely it'll gamify the whole concept. Besides that, you can always do some kind of giveaways through spin wheel and free fun wheel concepts to give free giveaways of your products, or even give free giveaways on a free upgrade to the next tiers for certain customers who are behind going to another tier. So what you can also do is, besides you launch your fundamental loyalty program with the transactional behaviors, you can also launch multiple other programs which are linked to non-transactional activities within the customer behavior. So maybe you want to like give them certain points and benefits when they are liking your posts or like sharing your posts, or probably sharing a testimonial video, probably you would like to reward them. So besides this, what you can also do is you can incorporate a lot of community-based reward programs. So communities aren't just standalone loyalty programs, but they instead serve as an add-on to another loyalty program structure, such as earn and burn that you have, allowing you to add new touch points to your original framework. Communities can be centered around a popular product, such as some people are very, very much likely towards basically being indulged into one of your good products. So what you can do is you can build a community around that and create a hobby or a lifestyle, and always keep sharing what new services that you're extending or new products that are coming in that particular category, and always keep sharing that content and also extend some exclusive reward benefits. So these communities always can be created in multiples. For example, you can also incorporate into their hobbies or lifestyles and always share some tips or some ethical values like sustainability and all of that. For instance, if you look at Sephora's Beauty Insider program that speaks about emotional benefits by offering exclusive perks like supplier-funded product sample giveaways and charged with makeup enthusiasts, which are incorporated in the program. At the same time, it also appeals that customers' rational benefits with clearly defined loyalty tiers that encourage customers to want to reach to the next status level. So speaking about that, so you also have value-based programs that you can incorporate where you can allow customers to convert their points that they're earning on the transactions to convert into for a cause, and clearly show them what cause basically these points are being sponsored, and that will definitely make the customers feel more emotional. So the next principle that we talk about is we have to always give that importance to speak to all the parts of your loyalty funnel. So all the customers ideally fall into one of your 4 points along the loyalty funnel that as you see on the slide. And the top performing programs holistically address each level in the funnel, from program awareness and membership to active engagement and the change to behavior. most organizations do a good job at some levels, but not everybody can concentrate on every level. So for the companies in the research survey that we did, the point along the loyalty funnel that represents the greatest opportunities between the point A and the point B, which you see on the slide, where customers have joined the program but aren't actively using it. So these are the people who signed up for a reason and are very motivated to engage, and companies definitely should take time to show them a way. So let me share for a small example here. Amazon Prime has created an ecosystem that engages customers along every level of the funnel. Prime uses free trials and clear communication with the benefits to convert 60% of the customers to participate, and compared to an average of 30% participation in general retail brands. Of the members who are participating, roughly Prime talks about 80% are being actively using their Prime membership, and 80% of those active users increase the amount when they're spending at Amazon. Amazon is able to achieve these results by delivering differentiated benefits to the Prime customer whom they care about, including such varied benefits as free shipping, movie, music content, Prime Day offers. Amazon always basically raised this bar on the program with continuous additions and continuing additions of new features and benefits that they're trying to extend to the customers. So the principle two majorly stands on how you have to concentrate on each of the loyalty, every aspect of the loyalty funnel. So coming to principle three, you also always have to offer customers rewards for today and tomorrow. So the two attributes that are very attractive to loyalty members in many research surveys are also the accumulation of points for a big reward, as well as the ability to spend points sooner for a smaller reward. So always they need to have that excitement of instant gratification, and always they need to have that aspiration towards going to spend tomorrow and get better, bigger reward. The key point here is that customers always want to access to any more types of benefits. They want to feel like a program is working for them in the short term, while they also know that it can also work for them towards something which is quite substantial in the long term. This is especially very critical in the sectors where products or services are more expensive and may be purchased very less frequently, such as airlines and hotels. In that case, instant gratification rewards keep customers involved and aware that they are benefiting from the relationship with the brand. So those rewards can appear quite normal. For example, a free sample from a store or a free drink on a plane, but are very effective. It's important to note that this isn't just about binary rewards approach. In practice, there can be a range of rewards to appeal different customer segments along the short-term and long-term goal spectrum. Right. So, for example, to take here, so Southwest Airlines, one of the good airlines, one of the airline company in the industry, offers the short-term benefit of free priority onboarding, boarding, and the long-term reward of free flights, and the additional value to add a free companion pass that members can always earn when they fly. So, this is all about the principle three, and going to principle four. You always have to make it easy for customers to understand and use the loyalty programs. In the efforts of enhancing loyalty programs, a lot of brands have tried to add all sorts of bells and whistles along the way. While adding innovative new features, it is also very much essential to for any program success. Throwing too much at customers, especially at one time, it can be very confusing and disencouraging. Companies need to definitely strike a balance by keeping the loyalty programs relevant to their customers and needs, while they also are very much accessible to and easy to use. So there is an outdoor simplicity outdoor retailer brand, a brand called REI, REI is the payback model if you look at, in which customers earn money back on every purchase that they make. And the kind of reward that they're earning, they definitely try to show that clearly on the receipts. So which makes them clearly understand, customers understand that what reward that customer is earning. And it definitely stays high marks from the customers and builds a lot of affinity towards the brand. So so these are the fundamentally four principles that you have to always think around while designing the strategy or while executing your entire loyalty program. So loyalty programs today have evolved from many years to today, from paper-based card systems to magnetic and credit card-based systems to mobile apps and omnichannel loyalty. Today, a lot of brands try incorporating a lot of omnichannel mechanism within their loyalty program by having them having the rewards accessible on web, mobile, and any channel that is in the store. It is possible for the customers. But today we talk about customer lifecycle loyalty, which is very important for brands to think on and relevantly design or give the rewards and benefits relevantly basis to the customer behavior and based on the segmentations that you're building. And even starting from communications, rewards, you always see the consumer behavior and learn the first-hand insight and then basically relevantly send the communications. So that is how your modern loyalty has to be built around. So let me, for us to build this customer lifecycle loyalty, just having a loyalty program in place within the brand is not going to help very much for the brand in terms of achieving their customer-centric goals or their loyalty goals. So let me share you a few fundamental agendas a brand ideally need to focus on in creating that long-lasting and meaningful relationships while you try to empower your loyalty program strategy. So what we talk about is a backbone for creating meaningful and long-lasting relationships. So while you have a beautiful loyalty program in place, fundamentally based on the four principles that I have shared on the last few slides. So data collection and enrichment definitely empowers your loyalty program, loyalty program's benefits to be designed in the right manner. So you need to have a great data collection and enrichment techniques that you incorporate within your brand to always basically understand customers better. So for example, if you talk about let's take one retail brand and understand like how you can make it easy, for example, to collect the data from multiple touch points. You can always run maximize your rich data collection from your customers by always running some kind of in-store promotions about your loyalty program, which makes it easy for customers to understand and also incentivize through these promotions for customers, giving them call to actions for scanning QR code and availing the incentives by filling up form details, by taking the entire demographic details of the customer. You can also print QR codes and URLs, membership URLs on your bill receipts. Besides that, you can also probably run social media promotions about your loyalty program, which are always linked with incentive and motivating the customer to go through a user flow where you incorporate data collection process. And you can also have a lot of call to action buttons everywhere possible on your product pages and specifically having a dedicated loyalty page, which talks having call to actions to sign up for the program and also talk about the benefits and the instant benefit that they are going to get. And you also definitely need to have the post transaction profile enrichment communications. For example, the customer makes a transaction and you do not know who the customer is in detail, but you only recognize them by identity of mobile number or email ID. Probably you can always go back to them and say them that they'll get some extra bonus points and participate or join our membership program. So while you incorporate a lot of data collection and enrichment techniques along your brand, it also becomes very important besides rewards to understand your customer experience. So what you need to do is while every purchase is happening, you always reward them. Besides that, you also need to collect your feedback in real time and make it easy for customers to complain. So for example, when you say you have to make it easy for them to complain about your brand or about an issue, so you always need to welcome customers complaining through SMS or email or push notifications, or even come down to your website or mobile app and raise an issue. And probably you encourage customers to complain by rewarding them. So for example, customer made a purchase and you trigger them a communication saying that, hey, we would like to understand your feedback. Probably you'll get 50 bonus points. Please share your valuable feedback. So, and you land them with a URL and ask them specific questions and understand the customer experience in a better way. So while you understand your customer data from multiple touch points, and also you have a beautiful reward program that is basis to your rewards principles. And while you also understand your customer experience. Now, once you gather all the data at one place, it is very important for brands to create those customer journeys And I just wanted to talk more on like what this customer journey is all about. So customer journeys are is the process of how customer interacts with a company in order to achieve a goal. Today's consumers interact with a brand in a ways that are tricky to pin down. So from gaining awareness of a brand via social media and to receive a thank you message for the order that they made, sending through an email after a successful transaction, there are usually many and varied steps in between. So you create customer journeys right from first touch point to very last communication, and also after the purchase, how your customer is going to see the communications from the brand over the next 1 year. Either you just talk about your understanding the customer experience, and probably when their experience is really great, probably you trigger them a communication promoting about your referral program and launch a referral program with talking about the incentives that they will get. So you can definitely do engage with customers with a lot of activities by upselling, cross-selling. So you can create those customer journeys wherein you decide what benefits you want to extend over the journey across the next 1 year or 2 years before they even make the second purchase or after the second purchase, and how you define your next steps for the customer. So along this customer engagement that you, along with the customer engagement that you define with respect to your customer journey, it is very important for brands today to incorporate a lot of gamification elements. So like I said, in loyalty program, you can incorporate a lot of gamification concepts like introducing badges and assigning some privilege status, or probably give them some 2x points for visiting on a particular day or visiting in a particular specific period of hours. So always saying them, also saying them that purchase XYZ product and tell them that they'll get 2x points or 5x points for a particular spend. So you can always gamify the whole concept of loyalty program. So the gamification can also be incorporated into your lot of other strategies. For example, your campaigns. So rather running a generic SMS and email campaigns, you can always incorporate a lot of concepts like with the fun wheel concepts, wherein you always say customer that engage with the customer by saying a good statement, be a lucky winner today for winning a free iPhone. And probably you send them a URL which they will engage with and make them spin the wheel and probably then talk about what benefit that you would like to extend. So a lot of gamification concepts can be not only incorporated in your campaigns, but also it can be incorporated along your referral program. So today's most of the referral programs, if you see fundamentally, it gives some incentive to the one who is referring and to the one who is receiving the referral code or referral link. So having said that, this is a very monolithic referral incentive approach. You can also gamify this by creating a lot of milestones. For example, in most of the case studies and referral program, the participation itself among your customer base within your referral program will be always less, generally stays between 10 to 20%. And if you have to either increase your participation rate or make every participant do more number of referrals, probably they need to see that substantial higher benefit in their milestone, in the next steps. For example, you create milestones like, hey, refer 10 people, probably you get a XYZ reward. Finish your 50 ripples, you get a vacation. You get a vacation for US and this is your free ticket. So probably you create those milestones with a specific number of referrals and then you set different benefits. Besides that, you can also always create leaderboards that are very experiential for customer within the website and mobile app, wherein showing them who have the highest points or who stand with the highest number of referrals, and tell them that in a specific year, you always call them up and talk about the benefits that you would like to extend to the top three customers in a leaderboard. So besides the gamification, it is important to build a lot of personalization elements within your entire customer engagement. So this is very important. And at the same time, you can also incorporate personalization by creating a lot of customer segmentation. So you need to have your customer data in place, and you should be able to like segment your customers with respect to their demographic behaviors or transactional behaviors, or their lapsed behaviors, and you try to understand what kind of communication you should send to what kind of customers at what point of time. Probably there are customers who visit only on weekends, and there is no point of sending communications to them on weekdays. So you probably personalize the communications to the right customer at right time with the right offers, and this is what we call it as personalization. And having said that, you always have to incorporate any of your marketing, loyalty, and CRM strategy that you wanted to expose to the customer in a very omni-channel direction, wherein customer should be able to access any reward or communication or see communications across SMS, email, mobile app, website, in-store. Wherever the touch point, your customer touch points are, you always need to incorporate all your benefits that you're trying to extend. So so these are the fundamental agendas you have to definitely, every brand has to focus on, besides creating a very strong loyalty program. So always every brand has to be very strong on all the elements that you see on the slide. So having said this, so what happens after basically incorporating a lot of aspects of data, from data collection to implementing loyalty program, you definitely need get that 360 degree understanding of the customer. So this is where you can take right decisions always as a brand and build that growth through meaningful relationships, which we talk as a most important thing in what you wanted to drive it through loyalty programs. So I would like to end this discussion briefing more on what loyalty programs are. And I would like to take questions from the audience and engage in a better way and have a real-time discussion.
That's great, Jeevan. Thank you for that. If anybody has any questions, feel free to unmute yourself, ask the question. If you have, you know, any comments to make, you can do that as well. It doesn't have to be a question. Alvin, I hope you're monitoring LinkedIn Live to see if there are any questions there.
Yeah, there's no questions. There's two questions in the chat. Mm-hmm. So Amir has asked, where do you get the info that 90% of loyalty programs fail? And Rajesh has asked, what metrics need to be tracked to determine whether the loyalty program is succeeding or not?
Okay. So first, let me address a question of 90% of the loyalty programs fail today. So that is a perspective towards basically what you want to achieve. So fundamentally, there are a lot of brands who try to implement loyalty programs and see a certain amount of traction. For example, your traction can be assessed with probably understanding what is your retention rate or how much percentage of customers are participating or registered on your loyalty program. So you might have a desired result of probably you want to increase your customer retention by 50%, but your current loyalty program technically is achieving only 10% of the retention. So that doesn't mean that basically the program has been successful because you have seen 10% of the result. So what can be done with a loyalty program is very huge in terms of what benefits or what models you can implement and what kind of tractions that you can really think to achieve. So the 90% of the loyalty programs fail today comes from a perspective of the brands whom as Froogal we have worked with, many brands who have already implemented loyalty programs. And when we assess their current CRM practices and when we currently assess their CRM strategies, so out of 100 brands that you take, 90% of the programs can be definitely enhanced in a better direction, which can give desired better results for the kind of tractions that they're seeing. And secondly, to the question, to understand loyalty programs, how can you assess loyalty program, whether it is being successful or what factors do you have to assess? So fundamentally, so you start with how many people, so you have, let's say, for example, 1 lakh user base. And fundamentally, when we understand how much percentage of the customers are actually participating in your loyalty program. So what it means is how many people have registered in your program and how many of those customers are fundamentally going back and redeeming your rewards. And if your redemption rates are less, then how are you basically taking actions as the next steps? Besides that, you created a tier-based program, and probably how much percentage of customers are particularly out of 1 lakh that you have, probably how much percent of customers are in X tier, Y tier, and Z tier. And then basically understand, basically how you have to set your KPIs towards basically the factors that you're seeing. So besides that, you always can compare your average spends with respect to customers who are not participating in the program, and also see what kind of average spends are there in your there with respect to your customers who are participating in the loyalty program. Always you see 30 to 40% of incremental positive difference in the customers who are participating in the loyalty program with respect to average spend. And if it is not, so of course, again, your loyalty program is not doing great enough with respect to your whatever the program that you have designed. So there are many factors, hundreds of factors that you can definitely look at from the standpoint of how you designed the loyalty program. So for example, if you have a gamified program, so how much percentage of customers are engaged into your gamification strategies that you have bought in? So it purely depends on the kind of program how it is being designed. You can define a lot more KPIs around that. So besides that, fundamentally, you can always set a brand score, a loyalty performance score, so which can be customized with a formula of different factors that you consider. So you can always define a particular formula for your brand, calling it as a loyalty performance score. So which can be defined from multiple other factors, starting from activations in loyalty program, redemption rate in loyalty programs. You give certain weightages to every aspect that you want to consider. And based on that weightage, you create a formula and you call it as loyalty performance score for your brand. And if your loyalty performance score is definitely growing, that means overall, with respect to the weightage that you gave to different aspects in the loyalty program are also growing. Hope I have addressed the question. So if you have any more questions, I would love to answer.
There are a couple more questions in chat. Rochelle, if you can read them out for Jeevan, answer them. And while Rochelle, you do that, I hope, some of you can attend our next event, which is after 20 minutes. Rochelle will also later paste the link there. It's a fascinating talk by Jyoti Bose. It's based on a book called Exponential Organizations by Salim Ismail. Explains how you can grow your organization 10x by using their EXO framework. So just a short note on that, sorry. And then Rochelle, you can read out the next two questions, please.
Yeah, sure. So we have a follow-up from Rajesh saying, how much is good? And Janvi has also commented saying, I believe building a loyalty program wouldn't be simple from a technical standpoint. What suggestions do you have for non-technical business owners?
I believe you're on mute.
I'm so sorry. So my audio went on to mute. So hi Rajesh, I would like to answer your question. So never anything is good. You always can achieve something best than what you're already achieving. So what we have to always look at is basically today, if you have 10% customer retention rate, so what is that you would like to achieve next year? Probably 15% is best. So again, compare that 15% to the following year, right? So it is always something, it is always important that when you implement loyalty programs, so are your KPIs continuously growing? Are your KPIs falling down? So you're definitely doing ultimately best if you're always growing. So that is what I can share as a feedback. And coming to the other question, I just wanted to, Rochelle, can you read the question again?
Yeah, sure. So Janvi said, I believe building a loyalty program wouldn't be simple from a technical standpoint. What suggestions do you have for non-technical business owners?
Yeah. So, see, fundamentally, a lot of businesses today, let's say if you take the entire restaurants, retail kind of segments, which are purely non-IT kind of businesses, and especially in the small and medium scale segment of businesses, you definitely see there is a lack from technology standpoint, understanding whether are we implementing a right technology platform for driving their loyalty program and CRM practices. And there are large brands who also take, who fundamentally, even if they have technical teams, it takes a large efforts for them to understand the actual technicality between different integrations between different systems. So it is very important to choose a right technology partner. So for example, what Froogal does here is, so Froogal is one such platform where, so we are a customer loyalty and engagement platform. As we speak, we help brands to drive their customer-centric objectives. So it is very important to choose a technology partner who have the solution from end to end. So for example, right away starting, giving you the ability to collect your customer data in an easy way, ability to basically launch your loyalty program to the desired goal that you have, and also understand customer experience, and also help you understand analytics, help you build that personalization, help you build that, help you launch that referral programs. It is always important to have all the aspects of strategy that you have incorporated into like one single technology platform. So for all non-technical business owners, it becomes very important to choose a right vendor, technology vendor. And at the same time, if the technology vendor can also additionally give value by giving managed services in terms of helping you think, also helping you think and strategize your loyalty program, helping you think and design your campaigns, and building your personalization techniques, helping you understand your customer lapsed behaviors. And if fundamentally somebody can do that, it will be really great. So that's where Froogal definitely adds a lot of value with the brands that we are working with today. So we almost work with 350 plus brands in different segments, starting from restaurants, retail, fashion, and multiple other sectors. And so what we do is we fundamentally don't just act as a technology platform while helping you launch your loyalty program, or helping you launch your referral program, or helping you launch your CRM strategy or personalization. We help you manage the service of executing the program, and also helping you strategize, and helping you ensure that you achieve your KPIs. So it's very important to choose right vendors and right team who always have the fundamental knowledge on everything with respect to CRM. So any more questions? I would love to really take it up and have a good discussion. So otherwise what we can do is, so I think consultant team is going to share the slides with all the attendees. And if anybody has any more further questions, or choosing to implement loyalty programs, or choosing to choose a right technology vendor, you can always reach out to us. And my mail ID is on the slide that you're seeing, g1@froogal.ai, jeevan@froogal.ai. So that's my email ID. Rachel, I think we are good for today.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Jeevan, and thank you so much, everyone who's attending. I hope we can see you at the last event from Konsälidön, from Connected Insights for the year. It's in about 15 minutes, and see you early in the new year with our new events. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah. Thanks a lot, everyone. Thanks for attending. Thanks for your patience. Okay. See you soon. Yeah. Thank you, Varun. Bye-bye.